Welcome to Bethlehem Institute of Engineering. Bethlehem Institute of Engineering is affiliated to Anna University, Chennai and approved by AICTE, New Delhi. This institution was established in the year 2008.
Now I am going to explain fundamentals and link layer in communication networks. In fundamentals and link layer, we are having data communication and all about networks. Okay, so now we are going to start with data communication. So data communication is nothing but it is defined as the exchange of data. That is data communication. So these data can be exchanged between two devices, through transmission medium. So through transmission medium such as wired or wireless. If it is wired, means you can send through coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, twisted pair cable. Okay, wireless you are having a Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, etc. Right, so data communication, it is the exchange of data between two devices through some transmission medium such as wired or wireless. Okay, and now we are going to see three fundamental characteristics of data communication. Okay, this is three fundamental characteristics of data communication, which is delivery, accuracy, and timeliness. Okay, so first one is delivery. So delivery means the system must deliver data to the correct destination. So that is delivery. To the correct destination, the system must deliver the data. That is delivery. Second one is accuracy. Accuracy means the system must deliver the data accurately. Okay, so accurate message should be sent to the receiver. That is accuracy. Okay, next one is timeliness. So timeliness means the system must deliver data in timely manner. In correct time, the system must send the data to the receiver. Okay, these are the three fundamental characteristics. What are the fundamental characteristics? Delivery, accuracy, and timeliness. Okay, the next one is we are going to see components of data communication. Components of data communication. Okay, so here we are having five components. First one is message. So what is message? It is just an information. Okay, so information to be communicated, with each other. Okay, that is message. So these information must be pictures, text, audio or video. Okay, so the first component is message. So message is nothing but it is the information which can be communicated between devices in the form of picture or text or audio or video. Okay, next component is center. So center, it is a device that sends message. Okay, so sender is a device that sends some messages. So it may be, for example, it may be computer, telephone, video camera, etc. Okay, so sender, it is a device that sends message. Okay, so it may be computer, telephone, video camera, etc. And the next component is receiver. So receiver means it is also a device that receives the message. It is also the device that receives the message. It is also can be a computer, telephone, handset, television. Okay, so these are the devices which receives the message or some informations. Okay, and next component is medium. Okay, so medium means in which a message travels from sender to receiver. Okay, so that medium may be, as I said, the transmission mediums will be twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, etc. Okay, so the components in components of data communication, we have seen the first one is message. So information is message is nothing but it is an information that can be communicated between devices in the form of picture, text, audio or video. Next one is sender. It is a device which sends the message. It can be computer or telephone, handset or video camera or etc. Okay, next one is receiver. Receiver means it is also a device that receives the message. It is also can be computer, telephone, television, etc. Okay, next component is medium. Medium means it travels, it is a path which travels from sender to receiver. Okay, so the message can be transmitted through the medium such as twisted pair cable, coaxial cable or in the form of wireless. Okay, next component is protocol. So protocol is nothing but it is a set of rules and regulations. Okay, it is a set of rules and regulations which can be transmitted from one place to another or one device to another. Okay, so a protocol is a set of rules and regulations that can be transmitted. These are the 5 components of data communication. So what are the components of data communication? Message, sender, receiver, medium and protocol. Okay, next we are going to see data representation. So data representation, the information which can be transmitted in the form of, as I said, text, numbers, images, audio and video. Okay, first format is we can share the information in the form of text, right? So text format, it can be represented as a bit pattern. The text can be represented in the form of bit pattern, that is a sequence of zeros and ones. Okay, next one is it can be in the form of numbers. So these numbers can be will also be converted to binary number. Okay, these numbers will be converted into binary number to simplify the mathematical operation. Next one is Next format is, it can be in the form of images. Okay, so images is also represented by bit pattern, and here it will be in the form of pixel. So each pixel is assigned with bit pattern. Okay, each pixel is assigned with bit pattern. Next one is in the form of audio or video. This format can be converted into analog or digital. Okay, so data representation, this can be represented in the form of text, numbers, images, audio or video. Okay, so text means it can be in the form of bit pattern, that is zeros and ones. Numbers, it will be converted into binary number to simplify some mathematical operations. Okay, images, it will be in the form of pixel, and each pixel carries a bit pattern. Okay, next one is audio and video. That is converted in the form of analog or digital. Okay, these are the data representation: text, numbers, images, and audio or video. Then next we are going to see direction of data flow. So direction of data flow means in which type the data is transmitting. Okay, there are three ways. You are having three ways. That is, first one is simplex. Second one is half duplex. Third one is full duplex. So first we are going to see about simplex. Okay, so simplex means it sends information in only one direction. Okay, it can send information only in one direction. Okay, so this is one of the device, and you can send information in only one direction. Okay, so for example, main example is radio station is the best example for simplex type of communication. Okay, next one is half duplex. So here the data can be transmitted in both direction. Here the data can be transmitted in both direction, but it cannot transmit at same time. The data can be transmitted in both direction, but not at the same time. Okay, so here the example for half duplex is walkie-talkie. Okay, so if it is a workstation, one means you are having another one workstation. This is considered as workstation 2. Okay, so the transmission will be started from this side, center side. If you are transmitting data, at time 1, so from receiver side they cannot transmit the data reply for this particular data at time 1. This workstation 2 should send the data at some other time. Okay, so now at the same time they cannot transmit the information, but at different time they can the both devices can transmit or receive the data. Okay, So this is half duplex. So half duplex, the information can be transmitted in both directions, but not at the same time. For example, it is walkie-talkie. Okay. Next one is full duplex. So full duplex, here the data can be is able to transmit both direction at same time. Okay. So telephone is the example for full duplex. Okay. So in full duplex, information can be shared both direction at same time. Okay. So example is telephone. Okay, that's all about direction of data flow. So in fundamentals of data communication, we have seen what is meant by data communication. It is the exchange of data between two devices. Okay, through some transmission medium. The transmission medium may be wired or wireless. And also we have seen the fundamental characteristics of data communication, which are delivery, accuracy, timeliness. Okay, the components of data communications we have seen as message, sender, receiver, medium and protocol. Okay, next, that about data representation, it may be in the form of text, numbers, images, audio and video. Okay, and the direction of data flow, in a sense, simplex, half duplex and full duplex. Half duplex means the data can be transmitted in one direction only. Half duplex means both direction we can share the information, but not at the same time. Example, walkie-talkie. Okay, next one is full duplex. So full duplex, you can share the information in both direction at the same time. The best example is telephone. Okay, next we are going to see the concept of networks. So what is mean by network? It is a connection of two or more computers or some other devices at a different location. Okay, from some other location we can connect different computers to share the information. Okay, to share information, that is networks. Okay, so if you are having two or more devices, we can connect those devices through networks to share our information. Okay, so we are having some network criteria. What are the criteria of networks? We are having different criteria such as performance, reliability and security. Okay, these are the network criteria: performance, reliability and security. Okay, next we are going to see about the types of connections in networks. Types of connections in network. The types are point-to-point connection and multi-point connection. Okay. So point-to-point connection means it is a link between two devices. It is a link between two devices, that is point to point connection. If it is a center, means it can connect only with one receiver. Okay, okay. So this is point to point. Next one is multipoint connection. So multipoint connection means we can connect or broadcast information to many devices. So that is multipoint. This is node 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This can be connected to multiple devices or multiple nodes. That is multipoint. Okay, these are the two types of connections. Point-to-point connection and multi-point connection. Point-to-point connection means only two devices, link between two devices. Multi-point connection means we can broadcast with or link between many devices. Connect a link between many devices, that is multi-point. Okay. Then now we are going to see about topologies. Topologies in network. So topology means it refers to the logical arrangement of networks. It is said as the logical arrangement of networks. That is topology. Or it can be say as geometrical representation of network, that is topology. So in topology we are having different types: mesh topology, star topology, bus topology and ring topology. These are the main important types of topology we are going to see. First we are going to see mesh topology. So mesh topology, I will draw the structure of mesh topology. So mesh topology means each device has the link with many other devices. Okay, so if this is a node 1, means this can be linked with other three devices, it can be linked. Okay, so and this device you can link with all the other three. Okay, can you understand? So mesh topology means it is a point to point links to each other devices, which can be connected to each other. Okay, that is mesh topology. So in mesh topology there is no traffic problems, in mesh topology. And also it has easy fault identification. Faults can be easily identified. But in mesh topology, this type of connection is expensive. Okay, expensive, and also installation is difficult. That is mesh topology. Okay. Next one is star topology. Next important topology is star topology. So star topology means they have a link to central controller, that is called hub. All devices will be connected to the central hub. So we are having one hub, all devices will be connected to the particular controller. Connected to the particular controller, that is called hub. Okay. So this controller acts as a junction among all these devices. Okay. So in star topology, in previous topology, mesh topology, it is very expensive, but in star topology, it is less expensive. And here installation is easy. Okay. And here in the disadvantage side, in star topology, we need more cables. We need more cables. So this is one of the disadvantage in star topology. The next topology is bus topology. Third topology is bus topology. Okay. So bus topology means all the devices will be connected to a single cable called bus. Okay. This is the cable end. We are having different tab. Each device is connected to the cable, which is called bus. Okay. So each device will communicate through these bus. Okay. If this device want to communicate with the device 2, means first it will communicate through this main cable that is called bus. Okay. So in bus topology, the installation is easy. Installation is easy and less cabling. Cable is very less. And this bus topology is mainly used in, it cannot be used in large networks. Mainly it will be used in small networks. And here, but in bus topology, the fault identification is difficult. Fault identification is difficult. Okay. So bus topology, each device will be connected to one long cable that is called bus. Okay. If the device want to communicate, means it will communicate through this cable, long cable called bus. So in bus topology, the installation is easy and here the cables used is very less. So it can be used in only small networks. Okay. Here the fault identification is very difficult. Okay. That is about bus topology. Next one is ring topology. So ring topology, here the network will be in the form of ring format. By forming ring, it can provide the network. Okay. So this is ring topology. So each device will be connected to next forming ring. Okay. So each device will be connected to next forming ring. So there will be only two neighbors for each ring, each device. Okay. So if you are considering this device, means this device is having only two neighbors. Okay. So signal is passed from device to device until it reaches the destination. Okay. So here each device functions as a repeater. Okay, can you understand? So ring topology. So this ring topology will form a ring to connect with other devices, neighboring devices. So here each devices will be having two neighbors. And here in ring topology, installation is very easy. And here the fault is easily identified. And and also here the congestion will be reduced in ring topology. Okay, that's all about topology. So we have seen about topology. So topology is nothing but it is a geometrical representation of networks or logical arrangement of networks, that is topologies. Okay, important types of topologies are mesh topology, star topology, bus topology, ring topology. So mesh topology means here the devices are connected to each other. So here there will not be any traffic problems, fault is easily identified. But here in mesh topology the network connection is expensive and installation is also very difficult. Okay, next one is star topology. So in star topology, here it contains one central controller that is called hub. All the devices will be connected in the through the hub. Okay, so here the expense is less and installation is easy. The next one is bus topology. So bus topology, all the devices are connected through one long cable which is called bus. Okay, in bus topology the installation is easy, the cable used is very less. So these type of topology is used in small networks. Here the fault identification is very difficult. Okay, next one is ring topology. So it will form the ring and the devices are connected in the form of rings. Okay, here also the installation is very easy and here the fault identification is very easy and here the congestion will be reduced in ring type of topology. Okay, next we are going to see network types. So in network types, LAN, WAN, MAN. Okay, so next one is LAN. First one is LAN. So LAN means local area network. So here if you want to connect a small area, we will use local area network. Yeah. Okay, for example, if you want to connect one classroom, school or a single building, we are using LAN, local area network. Next one is WAN, wide area network. So wide area networks means it connects large areas, that is wide area network. And the next one is MAN, metropolitan area network. So metropolitan area network, it is owned by a private company. Or it may be service provided by public. Okay, so here the MAN connects, that is metropolitan area network connects several LAN together. Okay, for example, branches of a particular bank within a city are connected each other. Okay, so that is metropolitan area network. These are the types of networks: LAN, local area network, wide area network, and metropolitan area network. Thank you.